Hey, I'm Troy.
And I'm Emily.
And together we are BU State.
And this is How to Wrap a Ski. Before wrapping your ski, you want to make sure it's nice and smooth, ready to go. Take off bindings, fins, grip tape, stickers, whatever you have on your ski, take it off, smooth it down.
Second step, make sure it's nice and clean. Get yourself some rubbing alcohol and a microfiber rag. Make sure it's just nice and clean.
Next step, gonna unroll your rack.
You're gonna wanna make sure it's centered, all lined up where you want it to go. Grab some masking tape. Place it over the middle. And skewer it down.
After that's done, I like to go through, make sure it's all the way centered. So if you have text that needs to be centered, I'll feel for the ski underneath with my fingers, and then you can feel if it's gonna be even with the edge of the board. So we actually landed up pretty good first try. If it doesn't, just kind of pick up one side of the tape, and then you can maneuver it if you need to. Then unroll to both ends, make sure it's gonna go straight to tip to tail. Completely covered. I'm gonna start at the tip of the ski. From here, this is where it starts to get fun.
So the fun begins. If you got two people, it's easier, but you can also do it by yourself. Make sure you feel the backing. Go all the way to your halfway point.
All the way to the middle if you don't understand Australian.
Like so. Grab some scissors, thank you, and cut the excess back.
Starting from the halfway point, peeled off the backing. Now, I'm gonna head this way as Troy adheres.
So all we're doing is nicely pushing the squeegee up and away, still making sure we're in the right position.
And that's where this material is nice. If it you stick it once, you can peel it back up a little bit, make any adjustments that you need to.
And you see I'm not putting too much pressure on the squeegee, just allowing it to slide over the wrap. Still making sure we're in the right position. Yep. And that's it, that's the first one done.
Alright, once the top half's been completely laid down, I'm gonna just lightly go back over it. Make sure there's no air bubbles in it. We did pretty good on this side. You can go around the edges and press just a touch harder, but nothing too crazy. Next up, the bottom half. So we're gonna take off the tape that's holding it down, because it's already stuck to the top half of the ski and it's gonna hold itself in place. That's done, water to roll, throw the first next to you. Repeat the same process we did from the center to the tip, just from the center to the tail. Feel the backing. It's easier with the buddy. Do that a couple times, but.
Repeat the same process.
Second, this part's always a lot easier than doing the first section because it's already holding itself in place and it's going to be square. You're just laying it flat.
But still check if you're happy with the position too, because you know, you can always pick it up and remove it if you need to. This stuff's really pliable. We use Avery Denison printable supercars wrap. So, this stuff's really durable. As you can see, I'm not pushing too hard and kind of just running my squeegee over it. If you guys have a squeegee or a credit card. So like Emily said before, you just go around the edges. Make sure they're nice and push down. That's the next step done. That's late.
She's wrapped. But now we wanna make sure she's gonna stay. So this is where your heat gun, or you can use a blow dryer, comes in handy.
Once you get the heat gun up and running, you kinda just wanna seal the edges.
For the heat gun, you don't wanna go too close or too far away. Too close, you're gonna melt, burn the plastic. That. You're gonna hold it safe distance, kinda like your blow dryer in your hair. You don't want it too close, it'll burn you too far away, it's not gonna do anything.
Alright, so I'm just gonna go around, Ellie's gonna heat it up.
Curves to the shape of the ski, exactly. Now it's time to trim. Handy dandy little knife.
Any kind of utility knife will do.
Box cutter or just a normal razor blade.
You want to make sure you got a nice sharp blade. I like using these smaller ones just because they're easy to maneuver around compared to a big utility knife. So if you can find yourself one of these ones, makes it a little easier. So first, I like to start in the middle. Make a little cut, like so. What you're gonna do is you wanna use the ski as your straight edge. As I pull along, you can see I'm just using the back of my blade and I'm running with the side of the ski. And I wanna keep tension on this outside edge that I'm cutting off so I don't get a jagged edge. It's gonna be a nice smooth edge. And then if you wanna stop, just take the cut it out. You do it in short sections, you don't have to do it in long runs. You're not confident. So once again, I'm using the back of the blade. Making sure I've got my excess in my hands. And I'm trimming all the way through. Like so. I can come up to the top. Do the same thing. Come all the way down to your ski. Make sure that back blade's touching. One thing you don't want to do, you don't want to dig into the ski. Otherwise you start digging out the wood and that's definitely what make it more divots in your ski. You can see it going nice and slow. Make sure it's nice and steady. Like so. I'm just applying a little bit of pressure to the ski. And I'm just gonna come through here and grab the excess. Once again, she's just making sure it's not getting that jagged edge. And come all the way through. There you go. That's one side done.
The tips and tails are a little bit harder, so we save those for the end. That way you can spend a little bit more time on it, get your solid straight edges out of the way, and then you can focus on the curve, on the tails, and on the tip.
I personally like going from the back of the knife, just so I can see where I'm cutting, but that's whatever works best for you. So same thing, you're gonna cut in, come all the way to the ski, just slightly pushing against the ski, making sure I'm not digging in. I'm just gonna run my knife all the way down. Like I said, if you have a friend you can help, it makes it a little bit easier.
We just noticed that if the vinyl starts to drop at all, that's when it's a little bit harder because it wants to pull one way and your knife's going straight forward the other way. So if you keep it straight, kind of like cutting wrapping paper, if you have that good tension, just zip straight through it.
As Emily said before, there's a little imperfection here. You just want to take your time going over these little spots. You know your knife's going to jump. And then all you do is just go back through and make sure you got every little bit that you want.
Make sure that edge is nice and straight. So that's where that divot is, so the vinyl went a little bit further past it because it wanted to cover that whole thing. So you just cut it off, so that's a straight line.
Now with the corners are a little bit trickier. You're gonna wanna pull it to the edge of the table so you can get some access to it. I like going over the top for the edges just so I can see a little bit easier. Don't mind our cat. As you can see, all I'm doing is doing the same thing, but going down. Putting a little bit of pressure on it just so I can cut it nice and straight. And there you go. As you can see, I can run it up and down, so then when I come into this section here where the vinyl is, it'll start cutting. like so.
And normally what I would be doing right now, since he's already way down there, I'll start by heating the rest of it, making sure those edges are nice and clean.
Now we just got the tail to go. Tail's a little bit more hot, as you can see, it's more of a 90 degree tone. Once again, I'm going over the top, having the bottom put back a little bit so I can get that jagged edge. Once again, you want a nice sharp blade running in the back of the ski.
I'm just gonna go around and look and see if there's any spots that he needs to kind of go over, see if it's jagged at all. We just like it to look nice and good and straight. And there's one little spot right here he might have to go over, but no big deal.
She likes picking up my work.
That's what wives are for, right?
So that's all done. Like Emily said, she'll go around now with the heat gun. The whole thing, kind of want to make sure it's at a certain temperature. I'll put it in the description or in the video. I'll insert it somewhere. And yeah, and then once you get it to that temperature, heat all your holes like Emily was saying. It'll easily mold into a fin hole. So like right here, I'm going to heat it up.
So he's gonna go around, fix that one little spot. Sometimes it's easier just to slide it off the table. Ah, she's all trimmed. I'm gonna go around with the heat gun one more time, make sure everything's stuck in place and good to go. Try and Emily with the bees to you. That's a wrap.